I'm going to describe a Rankine cycle on a pressure-enthalpy diagram. Remember, a Rankine cycle is a method for converting heat into work by typically using steam. And so the process is shown on the left, where we feed here at one a liquid into a boiler to create superheated steam. So this superheated steam is then at high pressure. It's fed to a turbine where the pressure drops, the temperature drops, and we get work out of by turning the turbine. The low temperature, low pressure steam is then condensed to a liquid, and that liquid is then raised back to high pressure, and we condense it into a liquid so that we can easily raise the pressure. If we were to try and raise the pressure for a gas, it would take much, much more energy. So we raise the pressure back to high pressure, feed the high pressure liquid into a boiler, and go through the cycle again. So to understand the behavior, let's look at this log of pressure versus enthalpy diagram. And so point one, so here it's a liquid, and of course it's at high pressure. This is where it enters the boiler, raise the temperature up to where it starts vaporizing. Here we vaporize the liquid. This is saturated vapor, and then we continue to raise, add energy until we get superheated steam. So here we have high pressure and high temperature, and high temperature is indicated by the high enthalpy. This is our feed to the turbine. And there's two lines shown here. This is a reversible one. This is an irreversible turbine. Reversible turbine, we're going to get the maximum workout, which means we're going to see the largest decrease in enthalpy. First law, energy balance, flow system. Adiabatic turbine, delta H is equal to W. So the drop from this value of delta H to this value, this change here in delta H, corresponds to the work that we get out of the turbine. A bigger drop, we get more work out of the turbine, and the work is negative if we're taking energy out of the system. The irreversible, we get less workout. It's less efficient. We end up at a higher temperature in this case for the irreversible turbine. Once, in this case, we have leaving the turbine a vapor-liquid mixture. That vapor-liquid mixture, mostly vapor, is then condensed. So this is the condenser, and it's condensed to a liquid. So here we have a liquid, but remember, it's low pressure liquid, saturation conditions. This is the liquid pump where we raise the pressure. And notice the line looks essentially vertical in this plot. We don't increase the enthalpy very much. This is a good thing because it does not take much energy to raise the pressure of the liquid. We get back to high pressure liquid at one, and now we can start this cycle again. And so the efficiency for this type cycle is related to how much heat we put in here and how much work we get out. The efficiency, well, and I should say the net work, so, but it's essentially the work over QH, but I should say network, in that the network would be the work from the turbine plus the work from the pump. This is a negative number, this is a positive number. So a small amount of the energy for the turbine is used to run the pump, where we have to put in pump work to raise the pressure.